Today, I'm going to show you how to properly balance your camera to a Ronin SC gimbal. Even if you don't own a gimbal, maybe one day you will, and I think you're going to find the information in this video very helpful. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. A lot of people can be put off by having to correctly balance a gimbal. And unless you're like, I don't know, an airline pilot or something, it can be confusing to know the difference between roll, tilt, or pan. But if you ever plan on using a gimbal, it is part of your job to properly balance the gimbal. Because if you don't, you can wear out and wreck the motors, as well as have poorly stabilized footage. But don't worry, it's not as hard as it sounds. And once you're used to it, you'll be able to perform the entire operation in just a few minutes. Since this channel covers a lot of Fujifilm gear, I will be using this Fujifilm X-T3 camera with this 16mm prime lens for this demo. And by the way, I will have a link in the description down below this video to a list of Ronin supported cameras and lenses, including Fujifilm. On this gimbal, there are three different motors, and each one of them has a locking mechanism on it. The first thing you want to do is lock down each of these motors so that you are in a starting position to balance your gimbal. You want to have it locked down where if you're holding the gimbal and this side is toward you, right, you can see the logo, the Ronin logo right here on the right. You see that? Next, if you happen to be using a zoom lens, then you need to decide ahead of time what your focal length is going to be. Put it on the camera, zoom to the focal length that you want, and that's the one you're going to use. What you don't want to do is put the zoom lens on the camera, put the camera on the gimbal, balance it, start shooting, and then adjust the zoom, because the act of adjusting the zoom will throw the balance of the zoom lens off, and that will cause you to have to rebalance the gimbal. Does that make sense? Next, you're gonna wanna get as much stuff off the camera as possible. You wanna try and get the camera as lightweight, right, for the gimbal. You don't want it to be heavy and have stuff that you can put elsewhere. For example, if you happen to have an HDMI transmitter, right, instead of putting it on the camera, which can weigh it down, you can attach it to the side of the gimbal and so forth. Same thing with a microphone. If you have a microphone that you normally attach to the top of the camera like this, even though it doesn't weigh very much, watch what can happen. If you go to do a move like this, it can hit the gimbal. You don't want that. That would make me mad, bad, and sad. You don't want to do that. So get the mic off the camera, and you could put the mic elsewhere, say on the side right here, which is why I have this little small rig cage for the camera, just for that purpose, so I can put things to the side of it. Next, make sure that you have a fully charged battery in the camera. The last thing you need on planet Earth is to have everything set up, fully balanced, you're ready to roll, and suddenly your battery dies. Or worse, your battery dies in the middle of your shot. So just change the battery beforehand. You don't want to have your battery die at all, right? So put a fresh battery in there. And the same thing with your Ronin. Make sure that your Ronin is fully charged before you start balancing. And finally, make sure that all of your camera settings are in place. Set your exposure, set your frame rate, set your focus mode, and so forth. Go ahead and put your lens on your camera, get all that set up. If you're using an ND filter, make sure that you put that on the lens first before balancing. Yes, this amount of weight can affect the balance, so get it on there first. If you're using a Fujifilm X-T2 or X-T3, I would recommend pulling the screen out, just like that. It makes it easier to see when you have it mounted to the gimbal. If you have an X-T4, then you could flip the screen out, but make sure that you flip the screen out before you balance the gimbal so that the balance process is taking into account the screen that you have flipped out and where that weight is. Now, the Ronin SC comes with a mounting plate with these two screws right here, and it also comes with this riser plate as well. The reason it has this riser plate is that on some lenses, if you have the mounting plate too close to the camera, you won't be able to focus the lens. You see that? So by using this riser between your camera and the mounting plate, it gives a little more room. You see that right there? You'll also notice on the mounting plate, it'll say lens,
light and heavy.
So you're going to want to have it adjusted this direction if your lens is lighter, and you're going to want to have it adjusted more in this direction if your lens is heavier. If you're not sure, put it in the middle position just to get you started. I think that would work best for most people. By the way, also on this mounting plate is a little marker. Do you see that? Now there's one other piece that's included with this gimbal kit that is for larger lenses, and that's this piece right here. So if you happen to have a longer lens that's on the camera, such as this one here, there's a little hole right here. You can attach this piece right there and it will help hold the lens and keep it balanced. Okay, we've got the plate mounted to the camera and we are now ready to mount the camera onto the gimbal to start the balance. Once you have the camera attached to the gimbal for the very first time, go ahead and lightly, and the key is lightly, adjust this tightening screw right here. At this point, your camera is now mounted to the gimbal. It's not yet balanced, but it's mounted and it should look like this. Now we come to what some people find to be the most confusing part of the entire balance process, and that is understanding tilt, roll, and pan, and how those balance together on the gimbal. On most gimbals, the motors are responsible for keeping your camera shots smooth and steady using a combination of tilting, rolling, and panning. The motors are doing this constantly. They're constantly making adjustments to these settings in order to keep that camera level and balanced. But by balancing the gimbal before you start shooting, you're sort of giving the gimbal a head start, and it's more evenly adjusted ahead of time, so that your gimbal has less work to do when you're out actually shooting. The first item to understand is tilt. Think of tilt as falling forward or backward, right? Forward, backward, forward, backward. Now the area that controls the tilt is right here. You see that? Now your tilt is actually the most complicated to adjust because it's broken down into two different parts. There's forward tilt and upward tilt. I'm going to show you how to properly balance those in a second. Next is roll. And think of roll as going from one side to another. This is roll. To the left, to the right, to the right, to the left. You see that? And this is the motor that's responsible for roll on your gimbal. It's the one that's facing you directly. Lastly, we come to pan. Now, pan should be easy for this audience to understand, right? I mean, photographers and videographers, what do? They pan the camera to the right or to the left. Same thing here. So the pan motor turns the camera this way. You see that? So now, to balance our gimbal, we will be adjusting the tilt, the roll, and the pan in that order. And with tilt, you will actually be making two adjustments, forward tilt and upward tilt. Let's begin the balancing. The first thing you do after your camera is attached to the gimbal is unlock the tilt motor right here. Now be careful when you're doing this because you should have your hand ready to catch the camera because watch this. You see that? All that weight, it's not in balance, right? So it falls forward, and the last thing you want to have happen is for your beautiful lens to go smash. What we need to do is adjust the position of the camera with respect to the tilt. And that is adjusted with this little mechanism right here. Simply loosen it a little bit, just like that, and you're going to want to move your camera. You see that? Forward or backward, depending upon which way that it is tilting. If your camera is falling forward, then you're gonna wanna push it back to better distribute the weight. So in this case, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna push it all the way back. So if I move it too far back this way, the camera's gonna flip up that way. If I move it too far forward this way, the camera's gonna come down crashing this way. It's a matter of balance. There, how about that? Check it out. That's about what you want it, so that the camera is not going forward or backward, but it's kind of evenly right there. Now, what you want to do is once you've gotten that balanced, you can mark the position with this little marker right here. I'll be honest, I almost never use this, but some people may find it handy. The next adjustment is the second one to the tilt called the upward tilt. Basically, you want to be able to lock your camera where if you have it pointed straight up like this, if you let go, it doesn't fall. You see that? That's not balanced. And the way that you balance that is on this adjustment screw on this side right here. You see this? I will go ahead and make the adjustment now. Same as before, it's a matter of moving it forward and backward until it just stays where it is. And then when you have it where you like it, go ahead and tighten. So there we go. The upward tilt is now balanced and the forward tilt is now balanced. Once you finish balancing the tilt, go ahead and lock it. Next, we're gonna balance the roll. Remember, that's left to right, roll. To balance the roll, you simply get your hand ready to catch the camera and unlock the roll motor mechanism. So you go ahead and unlock the roll motor like that. And now if you let go of the camera, say it's not balanced, but it's not bad, but it's not complete. That's pretty close. Sometimes the camera will just whip down like that, but this isn't too bad, but we can definitely fix this and make it more balanced. And so the way to adjust it is you're going to move the camera right or left to offset this. So when you're loosening this screw, be careful. You don't want the camera to go forward or backwards because then you're gonna have to fix that problem again. So you wanna just loosen it a little bit. And then what you do is you slide it that way, right? That's too much. Or you slide it the other way to bring that balance back. There we go, that's good enough. Go ahead and tighten it up. As you did with tilt, go ahead and lock it when you're finished. So now I've locked the roll. And finally, we're going to adjust the pan. And the pan is located right here. This is the pan motor. Now, the way that you adjust the pan is you unlock the pan motor so that the gimbal is freely turning in the pan direction, right? So then what you do is you rotate the gimbal to the left or to the right. You kind of turn it this way. See that? See how the camera tilted like that? If I rotate it the other direction, you see that? It's falling. It's going that's not good. You don't want that. So what you want to do is you want to make an adjustment to the pan motor right here. And again, you're kind of adjusting it forward and back along this pan axis. So I'm going to bring it all the way. If I bring it to here, now I take it and I turn it this way. Is it okay? Oh, look, still a little bit. The pan is my least favorite motor to adjust. By this time, I'm pretty much done with this and want to start shooting. That's not bad. It's staying still, you see that? Okay, now let's test our work. What you wanna do is unlock all three of the motors and see what happens. But remember to have your hand ready in case your camera is falling forward. I'm gonna unlock the tilt, I'm gonna unlock the roll, and I'm gonna unlock the pan. Everything's unlocked, now I'm gonna let go of the camera. Whoa, and it fell. See, by monkeying around with one, we screwed up the other two. So now it's a process of just fixing, it looks like, just the tilt is out of place. So let's fix the tilt a little bit. You gotta make an adjustment to the tilt. There, see? And that's good enough, okay? Now, what you wanna do is turn on the gimbal. Remember, never turn the gimbal on when you have these motors locked. Turn on the gimbal when they are unlocked. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the gimbal. Okay, gimbal is now on. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is check your balancing work with the DJI app, which will automatically look at it and do a quick test and tell you if you've balanced it correctly. Here's how you do that. Go ahead and open up the Ronin app on your phone, tap the Ronin, and there it is selected right there, and simply tap on balance test. And it pretty much tells you what you need to do. So you want to hold it at an incline just about like that. You see how I'm holding it just like this? And then, I don't know which camera to look at. And then simply tap begin test. It is now running a test. You see that? We'll see what grade we get. Okay. Oh, have a look at this. Have a look at this. Excellent, excellent, excellent. We got an A+. How great is that? And you can just feel, you know, when it's balanced, you could just, it just has this kind of gimbal balance feel to it, right? Look at that. Now, if you plan on using the buttons on the back of the gimbal to control the camera, you're going to need to do so using this USB cable that comes with the gimbal. Simply plug this end right here into your camera, and the other end goes right into your gimbal. Now, in order to use this attached cable, you're going to have to make a setting change to your camera. Do this though before you balance your gimbal. Go into the little wrench of the camera where it says connection setting and scroll down to connection mode. Change that to USB tether shooting auto. There are a lot of topics for future videos that we could revisit on how to use a gimbal. However, balancing is basically the first and most important concept for you to understand with any gimbal. If you would like to see more gimbal tutorials, please don't hesitate to let me know in the comments down below. Well, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I will see you again in another video real soon. Take care.